Good.
Yes, good evening all. I would like to, it's an honor for me to introduce my one of very best friend, Aditya Uday Dharmadhikari. Most of our Rotarian know about Aditya Uday Dharmadhikari. Name itself, it's you know, very much to say about him. But apart from that, for other members who do not know about him, he has done his MBA in 2012. And when it comes to his profession, he is a sales and marketing profession in the automobile sector. Currently, he is associated with KTM brand in Bajaj Auto Limited. And prior to this, he was working with Mahindra and Mahindra. And when it comes to his interests, he is an automotive buff, then golfer, stand-up comedian. From this interest, maybe I would like to, you know, propose our committee to maybe we can someday introduce him as a speaker, as a, you know, stand-up comedian also. And that will be very, very different, you know, attraction for all the other Rotarians. And today he's going to play the role as a moderator. And at the same time, I would request Aditya to, over to you, Aditya.
Thank you, Jignesh, for this lovely introduction. It could not have been better to be introduced to such an august audience by my own colleague, a person who spent 4 years of his precious life with me. Please don't get my statement wrong. We lived in separate rooms. Yeah. So it's my honor, and I thank the entire team at Rotary Pune, Mr. Naman Vinay Kumar Oja. I'll be just sharing a small brief about him through my screen. Just give me a second. So here we are, speaking cricket with Naman Oja. A right-handed top-order batsman, captain, wicket-keeper, hails from the heart of India, Madhya Pradesh. Debut in cricket in 2000-2001. Major teams played for, of course, an Indian international cricket team, India A, Central Zone, Madhya Pradesh, India Board President's 11, India Green. Honestly, I've not mentioned all the names because the list can just go on with Naman. An IPL debut in 2009 for Rajasthan Royals versus Mumbai. He's been a part of three IPL teams. One of the rare players in the IPL history to do that. Rajasthan Royals, Delhi Capitals, and then the Sunrisers of Hyderabad. Powerful stats. While I was looking up these stats, trust me, 7,000 plus runs in first-class cricket, 2,200s, 55 50s, 450 dismissals behind the stumps. That innings of 219 versus Australia A. Trust me, Naman, I am a cricket buff. I watched it, and it was brilliant. Captain of India A versus Australia A, the current captain of the MP Ranji team. 94 not out, Rajasthan Royals versus Chennai Super Kings. Woof, you whacked them. I've never seen Dhoni in tension, trust me. I've never seen Dhoni in that tension, especially the hook six that you hit over fine leg. 79 versus Kings 11 Punjab, good you whacked them, I hate them. 100 plus IPL matches, 1500 runs. The list can just go on. So here I bring to you Mr. Naman Oja, the ever so smart right-hander batsman, wicket-keeper, and captain. Naman Oja, thank you very much for joining us today at the Rotary Pune Central Zoom meeting. Naman. Naman.
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yes, thank you so much. Yes, I can hear you. Thank you so much for joining us and giving us your precious time this evening, a Saturday evening. Bad times outside, but great to have you with us today. And don't worry, I'm not going to be Karan Johar. I'm going to be very, very nice and be very, very, very around cricket. So, thank you, Naman. First of all, let me just start off, you know, with a very standard loosener. To you, the journey of cricket, Naman, how did it all begin?
It was from Devas. I think I went to my nani's place. I think she, all my nana nani is from Devas. And I live in Ratlam. So usually we go for a summer vacation there. So they have a camp going on in front of my nani's house. So morning 6 o'clock it starts. So I, and we sleep at on the roof because there was no ACs and everything, as you know that.
Yeah, sure. Absolutely, yeah. Yes.
So I just get up in the morning and I just saw that there is cricket camp going on and I'm very fond of cricket. So first day I went, then I start, and I was very young actually. I was around 6 years, 5 or 6 years, and I started going there. And from there, I think Mr. James, Josh Chaco, and he saw me one day in school and he told me, why don't you come and join Ashutosh Cricket Club? So I said yes, and then after 2-3 days I went there. Then I playing start with tennis ball, and then Arun Singh sir, like one of the and then after two or three years, I think he told my parents and me that you have to go to a place where you are cricket better. Then I went to Indore under Sanjay Jagdale sir at the cricket CCI, which is when I was 13 years, I just stayed in a room here and I started my practice under Sanjay sir's guidance. And then after 3 years, 4 years, I played local cricket in Indore and I got runs and got selected in under 19. And then I got when I was 17 years, so I got selected in under 19 Kuch Bihar Trophy for Madhya Pradesh. First two games, I got out early. And then in third game, that was a decider match of my career. And I got 183 against Uttar Pradesh.
Wow.
So first day I went to bed at 9:30. I got 100 at 11 o'clock. So one and a half hour, I got 100.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it was a 3-day match and I got 100. And when by lunch, I was 120 not out. And then everybody saw my batting. And then, you know, the buzz going on that we should pick him for Ranji. And same year, I got picked up for the Ranji Trophy and I got debut against Hyderabad under Chandrakant Pandit, Chandu sir's captaincy. So he took me from under 19 to Ranji team and I scored, I think, 14 first inning and 14 second inning against Hyderabad at Delhi College. And then the journey begins from there.
Brilliant. I think most of the great cricketers that we have come across, across the Indian cricketing circuit, have had a very, very humble beginning. So, Naman, you know, I mean, I've always heard, being a gully cricketer myself, and, you know, I also love wicket keeping. I used to be right there behind sledging those batsmen coming in. Why a wicket keeper? I mean, most of the guys, you know, they always say, meri bat, meri ball, main batsman banunga, main baller banunga. Keeper koi banna nahi chahta, honestly. Matlab, mujhe hi log, you know, last mein khada kar dete the wahan pe. Why wicket keeping? I mean, that really astonishes me.
I don't know, yaar. The day I went inside the ground, I picked up wicket keeping gloves only. I like the keeping gloves. So from day one, I used to pick up gloves and started keeping without any hesitation. I did it for almost 25 years. I did it, and 20 years I did it for Madhya Pradesh Ranji team, and 10 years in IPL cricket. But I've never thought of leaving keeping. But nowadays, really, my L4 L5 means my lower back really troubles me a lot. So that's what I means. It's tough.
I stopped bending down after a while.
I love to bend down. If my back is fine, I can do that. But sometimes, somehow I got stuck my back. So, it's very difficult for me to even walk after that. So
Great, Naman. So, Naman, as a wicket keeper, who do you look up to and why?
I look up to Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Mahi Bhai, actually. The way he has changed Indian cricket, and I think he has done... he has changed the parameters of wicketkeeper batsman. I think that's incredible from his side. I think, and really admire him. He is my role model. still he's a role model, and I love
I think Maivai has not only been a role model for cricketers, he's been a role model for corporates, he's been a role model for anybody who has spoken of leadership you know, as a profession and as an attribute. So Naman, let's talk more cricket here. What do you feel? Is the new game, is this new evolution of T20 cricket actually killing the erstwhile Test cricket?
Not Test cricket. I think it's very, very good to, you know, if somebody is good at playing T20, I think hitting ball out of the park, I think, you know, he can use that platform to play at the, you know, Test cricket or, you know, what I did is, because, you know, you have when you have some financial backup, then, you know, it's very easy to go on the ground, you know, spend 6 hours on the ground. I think it's very, very easy. But if you are not financially very sound after some time, you know, there is a lot of pressure of family. And, you know, so it comes up. But, you know, when this IPL thing come up, so it's very, very easy for me, you know, to perform there and, you know, play around the year. I can play cricket, I think. So I just thought of that if you have good money, if you have financial backup, if you are very sound from monitoring point of view, so you can play a longer, you can play a long inning, actually.
Absolutely.
Otherwise,
absolutely.
It's very, very difficult, you know, after, you know, 32, 33, I think you get married, you have kids, so you have responsibility coming on your shoulder. So, you know, with the, because still, I think Ranji, they don't, means it's, the income is very, very, not that great means.
True. Naman, your most memorable IPL innings, I know it's 94. Can you just run us through that short and sweet, how you hit that 94? And how was it to actually stand batting in front of your idol, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, and whack six sixes there?
Yeah, actually, you know, first seven games, I was playing for Rajasthan Royals and under the Shane Warne captaincy. And I've got attached with Shane Warne and Rajasthan Royals while playing for Rajasthan Royals. So, and you know, out of first seven games, we have lost five or six games we have lost. And we have to win after next seven. We have to win, I think, out of seven, we have to win minimum of five to be in contention. So, you know, I was, you know, in the pool session and I thought that if I want to make this team very happy, I need to win the games. I need to finish the matches. And that's what I thought from that game. And I took the responsibility over my shoulder. And I decided that if I get 20 runs, then I will not leave it for the others. And I will finish it till the last ball. And that's what I did in the game. And after that, I decided in every game that if I get 15 runs or 20 runs, then I will finish off the match for my team. That confidence I've got from Shane Warne, actually.
That's great. I think Shane Warne has been one of the greatest captain in the history of the IPL, the winner of the first ever IPL season. Just a personal question here. After the 94, what did Mahi Bhai tell you?
Yes, congratulate me for that inning. And I got a run out and I got a brilliant run out, which took Mahi Bhai.
Yes, that's why I asked you.
I was very happy. Otherwise, Mahi Bhai have won that game for CSK very easily.
Yes, yes.
So
Naman, has Naman ever sledged? Very controversial question. You may or may not answer, but has Naman ever sledged?
I did in my younger days, actually. When my seniors told me, I was very, very young and, you know, you have a pressure on yourself. So, they told me to do certain things and I did that. But after that, Sanjay sir know, Dardale sir know that I abused or I sledged someone. So, he told me not to do that because, you know, he told me that you have to play long, I think. If seniors say something wrong to you, don't do that.
I think Naman is a good boy. I was not one, you know. I was always known to be the bad boy sitting behind the stumps, you know, and criticizing the height, weight, length, though I was not fit myself. But yeah, I used to really criticize the batsmen. And by sledging, you know, honestly, I at least got 10 to 15 players out through my gully cricketing career.
But I try not to sledge as I now even I find very awkward to, you know, sledge.
Absolutely.
because everyone's, you know, when I do this, I think they don't look at me like that.
Yes, yes. And now a captain, I really think, you know, that's the image a captain of a very, very good Ranji team carries. Okay, Naman, what do you prefer facing, fast or spin?
Fast.
Fast. Why so? I mean, is it because the ball comes easily onto the bat?
I don't know, but if I play fast bowling first and then spinner, I think I'm very comfortable in both. But when I straight away when I play spinners, I think it's very, very, it's a little difficult for me to, because it's very easy for me to hit sixes still.
Okay, that's great. That's great. So, Naman, coming back to the Indian Premier League, you played across three teams. Rajasthan Royals was the first, and under the great Shane Warne, you had lovely players around you. Then you moved to Delhi Daredevils. How was the experience playing with a totally different team under a completely different captain?
I think Virubhai was the captain in the Delhi. And I think he's the best. I mean, he's also very calm captain I've played under. I think first 2 years was really, really very good for me. But only one point is I didn't got much chance to open the innings in for Delhi. I think I played a number 7. So for yes. 7, I think it's very, very difficult for me to play at number 7. I think because I love to face new ball and it's very easy for me after that. After that, when but at number 7, I find it very difficult for Delhi. But I kept really, I kept brilliantly. I improved my keeping in for Delhi. So I have a very means, and from there, I played Test cricket. So I think that's commendable for. Because the skill which a lot of people think that I'm not a good keeper and I play test cricket, I think that's commendable for my skill. Because a lot of people think that I don't belong to test cricket or 4-day matches as a keeper batsman. As an opener, I think yes, but wicket keeper batsman, they don't like. But after that, I improved a lot. But you have to give a lot from your back, I think. And
I totally get that, Naman. And now moving on to the land of biryanis, the place where you won the 2016 IPL. You batted with David Warner. You had the greats of yes. Kane Williamson around you. What a brilliant team. I think, you know, the match that they defeated Mumbai, I was very, very disappointed. I'm a hardcore Mumbai fan, by the way. You know, but yeah, I think Hyderabad has always been close to my heart. And I'm sure that is a team that has always been close to your heart too. So yes. How's been the experience of Sunrisers Hyderabad?
I think Shrikant sir has picked me in the in the second auction. First yes. auction I was unsold, and second auction and after I think 25 seconds or 30 seconds, just he has thought of that 94 not out of against CSK, and then he picked up that. from picked me, and after that they've not leave me for 4 years. So
yes so if I was in his place, I would not have left you too after that 94. I think the 79 against Kings 11 Punjab,
35 balls I got 79 against Kings 11. I think that inning, and after that I've gone to Australia. I've got double 100 in Australia, high in 100, and I got a dream 2-3 seasons. I got I scored almost 2,000 runs in that season, so I was in my best form of my life.
Yeah, I remember that match 79 versus Kings 11 Punjab. The most disappointed person on the field was Preeti Zinta. I cannot forget her face. she was actually, you disappointed one of the most beautiful ladies coming to an IPL match that day. How did that feel?
No. I think she is a very good owner. I think I've heard that she backs all his players, and that inning was very, very crucial for me. Otherwise, I would have been dropped from SRK, Sunrisers. So after that inning, I think I've got some command in that team, and Tom Moody was the coach, and he started liking me. But again, that I've not got chance at number three, because I've scored runs at number three, and then again they push me because of the team management wants someone else to bat at number three. So again, I was pushed. Fourth, I was not happy at playing at number seven. I think I want to bat at number three to score runs. I'm a top order batsman, but this is what happens, you know, where you can get a chance, you have to prove yourself. And the 2 years I proved in wicket keeping, I kept brilliantly for CSK. I think almost in last two seasons, 16 which we won, and 17, I think 40 chances came behind the stumps, and 40 or 45, and all took by me. Means is not a single chance it was dropped from my in that position. So I was very, very happy.
Yeah. So okay. Naman, while I was talking to you, I have a very, very interesting question coming up on my screen, which says that have you ever tried playing the helicopter shot since Bhai has been your idol?
No, not at all.
Not at all.
I think he's a legend. He's a legend, and he can play with the white ball. I think he is just champion. Champion player, so
yeah. But you know, there have been videos. There have been a lot of talk around this helicopter shot that it was first played by Sachin Tendulkar.
Sachin Tendulkar, where?
Versus Australia. There is a video which I came across, okay. And he did. I think he hit Damien Fleming over deep square leg with the helicopter shot. But of course, the way Mahi hits it, I'm sure no one has even come close to that. Even today. So Naman, going forward, there has been a new format that Cricket South Africa has come up with, the 36-over format.
Acha, okay.
Yeah. So how do you see cricket evolving? Do you see that Test cricket now starts, becoming only to the bigger teams, and then, the younger teams coming in, the Afghanistans, China has very recently got into cricket. So do you see that, the smaller teams move more into the T20 circuit, and Test cricket remains with the stalwarts, like the Australians, the England, the Indians? How do you see that happening in cricket now?
Yes, I think you are absolutely right. I think because, it's very, very, you have to, for that 4-day format, I think you have to nurture from, beginning, from, 4 or 5 years, you have to nurture the player to play Test cricket, I think. And these guys, I think Afghanistan, and they are very good. They are very talented cricketers in Afghanistan and all this Nepal and everyone. Because this Sandeep Lamichane I played with, I think he is very, very talented.
Yes.
So there are players, but I think they don't have the temperament to play for the 4-day. Because, 4-day, you need some time.
Absolutely.
One or two decades it required, to play in that format, to how to leave the ball, how to play the ball, how to be on the crease for the whole day without scoring runs. Because you have to, one has to be technically very, very sound.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So, he can play Test cricket. If you are not technically sound, you can play Test cricket. It's not that you have to score runs or you have to take wicket to play any format. But playing longer, playing longevity in your career, I think you require technique, proper technique.
Absolutely. I think, that you've absolutely pointed it out right. And that's the reason Bangladesh has certainly gone up the ladder in the Test cricket arena and giving a hard time to many stalwarts in the game.
Yes.
Apart from India, I mean, I'm sure you've been following the Indian cricket team of late. Apart from India, which other team do you see today? If you ask me, honestly, I think today's Indian team is the Australian team of the 1990s. Hard to beat,
correct.
Fighting it right to the limit. Where do you see, which other team do you see coming up and dethroning the Australians of the world? They've always been known to play hard cricket. Who do you see, apart from India, dethroning them now?
I think England team is very good. I think they have very good batsmen. They have very good bowlers. They have a very good setup now for ECB. I think England Cricket Board has set up very nicely, I think, for their players. They are paying really well. They are paying contract money really well. so that the player can really focus on the game only. So he don't need to think of anything else. The most important thing is, you know, how board look after his players, I think. So most important is, like, Indian team, I think they have IPL now. They have a big money in IPL players. Then they have a BCCI contract. Then they are playing. Then they are paying by match fees, allowances, everything. So I think one can focus only on cricket. So they can, yeah. Otherwise, I think it's very, very difficult. I think if you look at the Pakistan players, West Indies players, I think they are not being paid as highly as Indians and Australian players or England players. So, you know, after a certain time, you lose focus because of monitoring point of you or your family or whatever the reason is. You lose focus, and for the focus, I think you require that that big money coming in.
True, absolutely. I think that's the thing. So, Naman, one last question from a little bit of Buftagu, and this is a pure question coming in from my side. I've always wanted to know, World Cup 2019, India versus New Zealand, what was the turning point?
MS run out, I think. That run out by Martin. Not MS run out. I think still, if MS didn't got out, I think it's very, very little bit tough. You can't say not possible, as MS is on the crease. I think it's always possible. Anything can possible. But I think the second day, I think that rain, I think, played a very role in that, because that game start in the second,
yes.
Second day, and it was drizzling in the night. And, you know, balls start moving a bit from the day. So, it's very, very tough. If match has been played on the same day, I think result have been in India's favor. On the second day, they are mentally, they have got over us mentally.
True. I think cricket has always
That's what I thought, means Aditya. As I think that on the second day, they are very, very aggressive. They don't want to give any single. They are pitching ball in the right areas, not giving any, means they are not giving any freebies, no singles. So that's what I thought in the mind, that boss, now it's a bit difficult after.
Yeah, I think they really held it tight, and I think the entire country came down to blame Mahi Bhai. And the last photograph of Mahi Bhai's number 7 turning back and walking back to the pavilion. I think still rings in every cricket fan's mind. But honestly, I never felt that it was Mahi Bhai's mistake. The second run was only for the team.
Yes.
Yeah. So, you know, I think it was more left up to the top order.
Yes.
So, Naman, now from a little bit of looseness, we'll get into a little bit of rapid fire. And as you said, you like fast bowling. So, yes. I'll just ask you about 10 questions.
Yeah.
And answer me what comes on top of your mind.
Yes.
So, yeah. There we go. So, Naman Oja, the captain, last over 12 runs to get, and your idol Dhoni is on strike. Who would you ball? Jasprit Bumrah, Lasith Malinga, or Mitchell Stark?
At this scenario, Jasprit.
Great. Okay. The toughest spinner Naman Oja would keep to: Anil Kumble, Shane Warne, or Muthaiah Muralitharan?
Muthaiah Muralitharan.
Why so? I mean, is it the off spin?
No, it's got a very, very awkward turn, I think. So, ball, you know, spun from legs, and it's very, very difficult for a keeper to, you know, anticipate on the leg side. So, stumping chances or some edges also come on the leg side. So, it's very difficult to take.
Great. Okay, we move to the next rapid fire question. 6 runs to win. Last ball, bowling. Naman Oja on the crease. Where would you hit him? Over his head? Square on the offside? Scoop over the keeper?
Square of the offside. I think it's very, very easy for me.
Square on the offside.
Yes, yes.
Great. Great. Which spinner? And as you said, you know, you like playing fast bowlers. So, hence I'm asking you this. Which spinner would Naman Oja fancy hitting for a 6? Rashid Khan, Kuldeep Yadav, or Ravichandra Ashwin?
Kuldeep.
Now, the Chinaman.
Yeah, China.
Great. So, we discussed about your IPL innings, but I would still like to put this question to you. 94 versus CSK or 79 versus Kings XI Punjab? your favorite innings?
79 versus Kings 11 Punjab.
Brilliant. Brilliant. Okay, if Naman was not a cricketer, I think this is a very interesting question. And I've asked this to a lot of people who have moved into various sports. But if Naman was not a cricketer, then what would Naman be doing today?
Farming.
Oh, brilliant. Brilliant. Brilliant.
Okay. Farming.
Well, it's a difficult question to answer after nearly 2 decades into the game. I know that. But yeah, farming, I think still Naman could, move on and post his glory in cricket. Farming would be the right place to be. Okay, Naman, moving on to the next question. Your favorite cricket stadium, Eden Gardens, Wankhede or Chepauk?
Eden.
Eden, yes. Eden. The Mecca of cricket. Though I'm a Mumbaiite, I love Wankhede. But yes, the Mecca of Indian cricket, the land of Dada.
Dada, yes.
Okay. Now, we'll get a little personal. I know, cricketers, sportsmen talk a lot about fitness. But I'm a foodie myself. Roots of mine also come from the gastronomical capital of India, Indore. And here goes my question to you, Naman. I know it's a difficult one. More difficult than any question that I've asked you so far. Poha Jalebi at Sarafa Market or Johnny Hot Dog at Chappan Dukan?
Johnny Hot Dog.
I'm sorry, fellow audience. I'm sure if anybody has been to Indore, that's your place to go. Johnny Hot Dog at Chappan Dukan. Yes, there he goes. Even I go there, it's brilliant. Yes, yes, yes. The Poha Jalebi at Sarafa Market is also amazing.
Yes,
of course. Once all this coronavirus thing goes away.
I live too very close to Chappan, so better to go there.
So you still, I am jealous of you. You still would be having Johnny Hot Dog,
No, not now. This COVID situation come, we hardly eat out now. We don't eat out at all.
Yeah. Acha, Naman, I think all of us, even here, the audience, especially me and a lot of us, we just went out of work during this COVID and had very limited stuff to do. So we started watching web series. Which has been Naman's favorite web series of late? Or has Naman not got the time only to watch a web series?
Actually, initially I've got a time and I watched one, but I just don't remember the name. But I watched one. And after that, I decided because, when you watch web series, you get so addicted to web series that you watch till 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock.
Yes.
That's what I don't like to watch. And I try and then I start something else and try to... So we will not get disturbed by this COVID.
Naman, I call that second episode syndrome. Post coronavirus, I think that is the most addictive thing or the most contagious thing that I have caught. I've kept myself safe from corona, but I've not kept myself safe from the second episode syndrome. And it has really, you can see these dark circles down here. This is all web series.
Yeah.
So one last question that comes from me, Naman, from the rapid fire before I move to a spot the ball contest that we had held. We'll move to the open house. A couple of questions coming in from our members who are here. One last question. What is the perfect holiday destination for Naman? The deserts of Rajasthan, the jungles of MP, the hills of the north, or my favorite, the place that I'm born, the beaches of Goa.
I think I love to go on hills.
Oh, not the jungles of MP? Or you live around there if you've seen a lot of those jungles.
It's very hot, so better to go cooler side, north.
Great. Hindustan ka dil, Naman ka dil, aur mera dil sab ek hi cheez kehta hai. Bharat Mata ki jai. I would like to end this. And... thank you so much, Naman, for interacting with me. Thank you so much, Naman, for interacting with me. I will just open the house for the remaining members so that they can have a small question-answer session with you. So over to all the members. Thank you so much for your time.
Aditya, there are a lot of questions on the chat. If you could open the chat and then you can ask from there, read them out.
Okay. So Naman, I'll only take these questions.
Yes, please. Go ahead.
I have a question from Dr. Bande. He says that is Test cricket now becoming history?
No. Test cricket will not. Test cricket will remain. All format will remain as it is. As now, player will decide that what format they want to play. There are players who are playing T20 only. There are players who want to play one day and T20. There are players who want to play only test matches, like, you know, Jimmy Anderson. There are players, Jimmy Anderson, if you see Stuart Broad, Cheteshwar Pujara, I think they want to play for India or for England for their respective
country. True.
So, there are formats, there are different formats. I think after some times, board will decide or player will decide what format he wants to play. And now our Indian board, Indian and England board has already made sure that the player who is playing test cricket will be paid more money.
Yeah, I think that is very important.
That is very, very good thing, very good decision by the board. So that test cricket will remain at its best.
Absolutely. Naman, here comes the next question. Again, from Mr. Ajay Chitnis. He asks, what are Naman's interests beyond cricket?
Farming.
Farming. Wow. Wow. That's amazing. Which tractor do you use?
I have poly houses and I do farming. I do flower farming.
Okay. Great. I have another question from Dr. Bande, who asks, how is real life after all the limelight?
I think same. I have not complicated it very much and try to be grounded. And I want to remain same, means as a limelight. And I think limelight is a bit more flashy, means you get a lot of monitoring point of view. I think touch wood, I have not did anything flashy in my real life and done things on a very simple way. So I'm very much relaxed at this point.
Great. So I'll just move to the next question coming from Mr. Bhushan Thakur, who asks, what is the difference between sports training and sports education? And most importantly, what has been the role of your parents in all the developments and achievements that you've had throughout your life?
I think, first of all, sports training is different and sports education is different. I think you guys can now be sports educated. You can also, you know, education is, you can do whatever you want. Means education, you can take that sports. You require squatting, you require lunges, you require this to train this. But sports training, when you do it, I think on your own, and you do it 2 hours in a day. So that's a sports training. And the third question, in this question, that parents, I think parents really played very important role in my career, because, you know, I'm very, very much interested in cricket. I was, in morning 6 o'clock, I get up and go for practice. Then I came at 8 o'clock and go to school. And then again, I came at 3 o'clock and 3:30. Again, I went to practice. And then 6:30, I went for tuitions and everything. So, and I think, my father has trusted me to send me to Indore. My mother has trusted me that Naman, don't do. Means my father's friend told that what will happen if your son will not educate. There are engineers who have been paid 10,000 and 50,000 rupees. It's better to whatever he wants to do, he will do. And if he has not done that thing which he is putting his heart out, so we can open a shop for him. He can make 15, 20, 25,000 rupees anyhow from a shop. So you don't need to worry that means he is so interested in cricket. He is so dedicated in cricket. He is I've given all my life to cricket. So, and from that time, people can see that. So my father, then they sent me to Indore, and my mother used to come in every 13, 14 days to see me, that he has not got a bad habit or something, you know, because when 12, 13 year boy will go outside from house, I think there are a lot of exposure. There are a lot of friends who will take you to some places where, you know, there are, liquors and cigarettes and everything. But touch wood, we have not got, I've not been to all this company and by God's grace means everything. I think even you get money and you have, if you have bad habits, I think there is no use for anything. But so my father trusted me, sent me to Indore. So they both played a very important role. Plus then I got married, and my wife also played a very important role because she has taken all my pressure of family to her and to the home. And I focus on my cricket only.
That's great, Naman. Thank God, your parents trusted you there then, back then when you were a young lad. And, today we get to see you, Naman Oja, right here on our screen. And we've got to see a number of those memorable innings. I'll take a couple of more questions. As an opener, who do you like to follow? Whose batting style would you like to follow? A very interesting question coming from Mr. Ajay Dubé. Is it Virendra Sehwag, Viru? Of course, the god of cricket, Sachin? Or the contemporary champion, Rohit Sharma?
I think very tough question. I think Sachin Paji, I think is extremely, means he was God gifted. But yeah, I think Rohit is also very talented. I think Viru is also very talented. I think they all are. But I think the transformation of, I think, Viru Paji was unbelievable. From number 7 to opener, he was asked to open the innings, and then he's changed the dynamic of test cricket plus one day cricket.
I think Viru Paji not only changed his own dimension, he changed the dimension and careers of a lot of bowlers that came into ball. I don't know, I cannot even keep a count of how many of them lost their careers after they bowled to him.
Yes.
Yeah, so who would you like to watch? Another question coming in. Who would you like to watch? Who would you pay to watch? Lara or Sachin?
Both.
I think Naman will take a slip out of this question because it's a very controversial question. There are a couple of more questions that I can read. A question coming in from Mr. Bhushan Thakur. How would you handle pressure inside the field, and has it helped you handle the pressures off field, especially with your wife? I would want to know that,
I think inside, I think it's very tough when you are on the field, I think. But I try to stay calm and just focus on the job which was given to me, I think, rather than a crowd and everything. And at home, I think, again, same.
Again, there is a lot of pressure, isn't it?
Means... Touchwood means not at all at home means.
Yeah.
Still I go for training. Still I hardly give time. I am same still.
Great.
Yeah.
Great, Naman. Thank you so much. There are a lot of other questions that have come to me. I would request you. I will just put them across to you on a WhatsApp. And if you can give me those answers, I would give it to the respective members. Once again, a heartfelt thank you, Naman. And I think before I close the day with you. Just a couple of small things. We had run this contest of Spot the Ball, and we had spoken about this last week. And thank you. In fact, I would like to mention this to all the members. It was so kind of Naman in this kind of a scenario. He sent me his signature, and of course we could not get any merchandise, but we created some Naman-specific merchandise here, which is signed by Naman, digitally signed by Naman for the Spot the Ball contest. So before we move on, I would like to just put that question to Naman first, and then I would request my father, Mr. Uday Dharmadhikari, and the president of Rotary, Mr. Ajay Dubé, to declare the winners. We had about a good participation. A lot of people respond, got it correct, but let me see if Naman gets it correct. So I'm going to put that question to you. And let me see if you can tell me. Where did you hit the ball? Oh, I'm so sorry, See, that's what happens, digital I mean, you can, but I don't think Naman saw it.
I saw it.
he has been candid enough to.
Okay. Anyway, so I'll get the answer. I'll get to the answer. I could not keep this a suspense, but I'm sure this was a nice little hook shot. Naman, who did you hit this to? If you remember, among so many shots that you played.
No.
Oh, okay. I'm sure this the trajectory.
Sandeep Sharma.
I'm sure it landed at least.
Sandeep Sharma.
Who you hit it to?
I think
Pradeep Sharma.
Pradeep Sharma.
Sandeep Sharma.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyways, whoever it was, I'm sure it landed in the third tier.
That I don't know. Still, I don't know.
Okay. So now I'll hand it over to Mr. Ajay Dubey to take and declare the winners. So. Yeah.
The first correct answer we received was from past president Suhas Merchant. Where is Suhas? Let's clap for Suhas. And the second correct answer was Gajanan. So Gajanan also got it correct. And the last correct entry very late in the day we got was from Dr. Bala Sahab Bande. He got it correct too. So we got three correct answers, and we would also like to mention a special mention for Jayant Luthra. He was very quick to respond, though the answer was not correct. So we would like to give him a special mention as well. So that was a lot of fun. We got a lot of answers, and people, you know, put the ball all over the grid, which is very, very, it's very interesting, you know. And I wanted to guess as well, but you know, since I was part of this, Uday sent me the answer immediately after the question. I just couldn't participate. So thanks a lot. Thank you, Naman, and we would like to give you a citation. Can you bring that up? You know.
You want me to bring it up?
Yeah.
Thank you, Naman.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you guys.
Just hold on.
Talk and a citation coming and talking to us about cricket. All of us here love cricket. When cricket is on, nothing seems to else go on. I went and watched the World Cup in the UK last year, and I just came back before the New Zealand game. So I didn't watch it. I watched all the games with India once. That was paisa vasool for me. You know? We would like to thank Aditya for holding this session. It was really, really entertaining. It was a very unique concept for us to have a lively talk chat show for us. Thank you, Aditya, and thank you, Naman.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Naman.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
The meeting is adjourned.
Thank you, Aditya.
Thank you. Bye, bye, everyone. The meeting is adjourned.
From the program committee, thank you very much.
Bye, Rajiv.
Program of the year.
I would like to specially thank.
Thank you.
Uday for organizing it and sending all the teasers, and so we got quite a lot of information on what is coming our way. So thank you, Uday, as well. Can't see Uday.